Princess Serena, not Princess Serena, and today I'm going to be sharing with y'all my top five Disney trades that I've ever done that made my head go absolutely like Miss Selena Gomez over here. I was originally going to be showing you my top five trades in general, but then I realized a lot of them are fantasy and I don't want to discredit all of the ISOs that I've been able to acquire via trading, let alone find them in general. So today is just going to include authentic Disney pins. So without further ado, let's get into it. I'm going to attempt to show you them in order in which I traded them. And when this series came out, I was like daydreaming about an I Collect a Wall-E bag. Like I just love like a good meta pin, like it knows pins exist. And then when I saw a Pixar one, like Disney did one step up, they're like, no, Serena, I'm not gonna just give you your favorite Pixar film. I'm gonna give you them all. Well, not all, they're not all represented. It's a pin book and then it says I Collect Pixar Pins. And then when you open it, you see Wall-E, of course, with the little boots. And you also have Coco because of the skull, and you have the grape soda badge, and of course, Toy Story, which I thought they may have maybe done a I Collect Toy Story because Toy Story is definitely the most popular Pixar franchise to collect pins of. But yeah, they included so many of them. And upon first glance, I definitely missed the balls that are supposed to represent the emotions in Inside Out. So I guess they're supposed to be core memories because they're in the colors of all the emotions. And of course you have the Luxo ball in the middle, which you see through the pin book as well. And then you have a string. It's amazing. And it's limited edition 2000. Next up, keeping in the theme of I Collect Pixar, is Remy. I was going after the Pixar alphabet set, which is definitely still the grandest collection that I ever set after. That is one of my proudest pin trader accomplishments within my pin trading and collecting career thus far. But back to this beautiful Remy pin. So we have a Remy with the sparkly R. So the sparkly ones are the chasers, and this is an LE400. And it was the last letter I needed. I didn't have the M with me, so technically that was the last letter I added, which I did trade for as well. But it's because the original M I traded for was stuck at a P.O. box for like 2 years, which I will link that video of me finally opening those pins in January. He was so hard to find. Like, I'm kind of impressed that he is because you don't see Ratatouille pin collectors that often, but he was hard to snag, which means people collected him like out of the alphabet itself, but yeah, there's my alphabet, never touching that board. We got Mr. and Mrs. Evans here. It's just so rare to see like twins like in high school age be that close. It's kind of wholesome. Makes you forget they're the villains of the film, but stop, we're rooting for them. Get out of here. They worked hard for their success. They like, at least were talented. They didn't just like get into the musical and like, they just like bought their way. This is from the High School Musical 3 prom and their outfits. And I love it. I love the border and like the music notes and the stars and the hearts. And it's great because it's just like an actual photo of them. So it's kind of less creative, but I like when they put like enamel elements and like little designs to add onto like the real people on here. So I love that. And it is huge. It is limited edition of just 300. In the same trade, I got Chad and Taylor. I cannot believe this is the only pin of those two together. Like, that is unacceptable, please. Taylor, I mean, please. I talked about why I loved her in another video somewhere. I'll try to find that and link that. But we got Chad and Taylor in their bum outfits here. Same style as the other pin, and it's also limited edition 300. I literally forgot to show you this, so I just had a little setup quickly. Yeah, so this is Ray from Finding Nemo, and he is one of the two chasers in the Finding Nemo Character Connections puzzle set. And not only did I find him, I traded for him. He was my first pin mail of 2021, I remember, and quite the pin mail at that. And this is just one of my favorite puzzle pieces in general as well, because it's just so vibrant and I don't think his character gets enough pins. It's a limited edition of 600 because it is a chaser. The rest are limited edition of 900. Let me swim away to your regularly scheduled programming. So the fifth and final trade is actually from about a bit over a year ago, and it is one of the bulkiest trades I've done. As I was dealing with this trade and I was trying to find a pin he liked for that, Perry got word of a very diabolical plan being thought of by Miss Princess Serena here, yours truly, that I wanted to start a new collection, but he wanted to put a stop to it. So he made sure that Jonathan didn't like any of my traders, but that didn't stop me. I went all around Canada to try to get a bunch of pins that he liked, and I ended up getting 21 pins. Okay. And then I got like about 10 in return because it's limited edition. I started with a blood drive that is so random, but also starting this collection is pretty random too. So it's fitting. But basically I was like, hey, like, why don't I collect a Hanukkah pin per year? And I made it a goal of mine to get all of the years. So I had to get 2000 to 2020, and I only had a 2017 one as a head start. And I managed to actually get that goal by November, I believe, this past year. So that was amazing. So since I thought of this idea, like, I asked Jonathan, hey, do you like happen to have Hanukkah pins? And he's like, oh yeah, I happen to have like a ton. And I was like, what? So I traded for all of them. So I have the 2004 one, which is an LE 1500, and the dreidel actually moves a bit there as well. And so I also got 2005, and it's also a LE 1500. So that's why I'm so surprised to like find them all in one place. Surprise, surprise. Can you guess what's next? 2006. So we got Tinkerbell, and there's another Tinkerbell pin, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, there's another Hanukkah Tinkerbell pin. I hope they continue to do new characters that aren't in any of the pins. They've been doing pretty well with that starting in 2019. So Jonathan didn't have 2007, but he had 2008. But 2007 actually ended up being one of the final three I needed. This one, another Chip and Dale, and we got Chip lighting the menorah and Dale just playing with the dreidel, and it's so cute. And this one's a limited edition of 3,000, more accessible, we like it. And then we are skipping all the way to 2016, and this is like the coolest one, I find. Not my favorite one, but it's definitely the coolest one in the sense that like this just, it spins so cleanly, like look at that. Cause there's no like area that it's like confined to, like this part's open. So I find that really cool. And I believe he had the 2017 one, but of course I had that one. So I went for 2018, and this one's one of my favorites. I love every shade of blue to ever exist. So I just love the blends of colors here. And finally for the Hanukkah pins, we have the 2019 one. I'm allergic to cats. My eyes will literally swell shut if I'm like staying in a house that has like a cat and there's like fur everywhere. But yeah, speaking from experience, 2019, that would have been hilarious if that experience happened in 2019, but it didn't. But this is an LE 3500. Okay, on the up and up we're going. All right, well, I mean literally the 2021 pin was limited release, like it's just getting more and more common these days. And then I also managed to go above and beyond the pins that I needed to trade, so I was able to pick some more, and I got this LE1000 Wally pin, and I love the grid background. I think that's really cool. And then you have Wally putting in garbage into himself, and it says, building the future, construction begins 2008, which is when Wally premiered. And yeah, I just love the shade of blue against Wally's gold and brown tone. I think it stands out so well, and I just love the contrast. Here's an overview of my top 5 trades. I also put the Alien Remix board behind me because I actually traded for all of those as well. So that's it for my top 5 pin trades that I've done online. I hope you enjoyed. And if you haven't already, please subscribe for more pin related content from me every Tuesday. And I'm definitely going to be doing a top 5 fantasy pin trades that I've done. There were definitely more contenders for this video, but you know, I have a top 5 series going on, so I had to constrict it. But I technically did a top 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, all the way blast off to 24. Because, I mean, technically, some of them I did more than one. So, I know, at least 10 more trades are in here that I included. And as always, take care of yourselves and have a magical day. Bye!